This represents 22 strain gauges, and each one of these connectors represents one measurement, or one single point measurement along the length of this simulated wing. While the second technology that we're featuring on this simulated wing is based on fiber optics. This is a single fiber optic cable, so this particular connector right here represents on this particular installation 321 measurements. That's a measurement every quarter inch along the length of this panel and back towards the root. So the difference is you can see that 22 sensors, 321 sensors, and you can see the weight difference and the size difference and the bulkiness between the two technologies. And just to give you a little demonstration, we have data flowing on the computer here that's going to show not just the strain information along the length of this panel, but as well as the shape rendering of this panel based upon the strain content that we're getting from the fiber optic sensors. Here we're just doing a simple bending that simulates aerodynamic loading in the downward direction. Here is in the upward direction. I'm going to simulate what we call twist. You can see that on the top left graph. This is twist in the opposite direction. And also we'll introduce a second mode here in the middle of the panel. You should be able to see that as well. So there you have it. Fiber optic sensing installed on a simulated wing showing both strain and shape information.
So the next step for the fiber optic sensing system technology here is going to be to design a ruggedized system that will be able to survive the space application, so a rocket launch. We've done applications before where on airplanes that within Earth's atmosphere, but the next step is going to be space application here. So you see here is the actual avionics system, the actual electronics of the FOSS system. So the next step is going to be putting it into the ruggedized enclosure that has been specifically designed and tested to survive a space application, a rocket launch. But it's been ruggedized, so the next step here is going to be to install the actual avionics systems, the actual electronics of the FOSS system into the ruggedized enclosure here. After we finish the full integration of these systems and we torque everything down to spec, then we'll ship them off to Langley, the NASA Center, which is going to be responsible for the environmental testing and qual testing these two qualifications of spaceflight.